In our part 2 video, we talked about two ways of altering the material around the pin to retain the pin. But this video will talk about two ways that we can retain the pin internally just by altering the pin itself. A splined pin has little ridges on it that make the pin diameter slightly larger. In fact, it is slightly larger than the inside diameter of the knuckle. The splined pin is then forcibly driven into the curl, and the splines wedge themselves into the inside of the curl, therefore making the pin stay in place. A coin pin is another similar way of internally retaining the pin. One end of the pin is smashed flat, and again, making the width of the flat part larger than the inside diameter of the curl. The coin pin is then forcibly driven into the curl, and a larger pin width holds the pin in place because the pin is now wedged into the curl. And don't worry, these pins aren't going anywhere, but if you need to remove them, it's difficult, but you can still drive these pins out of the hinge with a bit of effort. Still think we're done? Well, at Guden, we're all about offering you many options so we can meet almost any need or request. So see you in part 4 for even more pin retention choices.
Sit, Hingy, sit!